So now we have the next presentation is about usability testing with three people, how to discover why mappers are confused by your software. And we have Mateusz Konieczny. The presentation is based off his own experience with user testing while developing StreetComplete. So thank you, Mateusz, and the floor is yours.
Hello, everyone. And I want to share a bit what I learned, and hopefully it will be useful, and maybe even not directly useful to show how certain things are developed. So my proposal is to try to actually looking how people are trying to use software and consider fixing the problems that are common among them. And the trying part is actually true, and that is exactly why it is worth doing this. And I'm not claiming that I discovered something. It is completely something that where I found useful advice and I use it and it worked, so I want to share it further. I first encountered in writing of this specific person, and he recommended, had set of recommendations for sane software development company, and among them was to basically try actually using the code that you are producing, and he recommended five people. And another kind of related example is Notre Dame Fire. It was not a big surprise. It was a place that was had regular training for firefighters. They had a special fire detection system. They had prepared plans and so on. They had daily inspections. But when the fire actually started, it was detected by the system, but system had so confusing interface that the guard was sent to check what is going on into wrong location. And once the problem was discovered, the fire was so gigantic that it was impossible to stop easily, and it caused massive damage. It was discussed in a few places. For example, in one place, someone mentioned beer testing, and someone asked, what the heck is this? And the answer was that is to basically take your project, go to pub or into a place like this, and offer people some beer in exchange for testing what you prepared for 5 minutes. And if this system would be tested, the problem would be spotted, because it was so obvious that just any amount of testing would discover it. It is actually worth trying this, even if someone is convinced that their system is great and everyone understands what is going on. And just in my variant, I follow this exactly, just with the difference that I used ice cream instead of beer. There's also known under more serious names. I heard some advice that usability testing and user experience testing is not actually the same, and there are some differences. I admit that I tried to check them, found some definition, I forgot the difference again. At least in my opinion, it's not so important. More important is to actually do some testing at all. Basic recommended plan is to find some people, convince them to spend few minutes trying to use app, program, or something similar, and actually look how they are doing. And There are some recommendations to record the screen. There are some esoteric options to record where they are looking at the screen. I guess that it can be useful, but if someone has no access to something like that, just looking what are they doing is enough to be very, very useful. And ideally would let them experiment and to avoid the situation when author is knows what is supposed to happen and constantly points on the screen what should be clicked. It may be necessary when they got lost completely, but ideally just looking what they are doing and following and making notes what was going wrong. And some people have image that such user testing requires some thousands of people, hundreds of people that you need to run some massive program to have something useful. That is not true at all. Testing on single person can be useful, but it is hard to distinguish specific person being confused by something or having a systematic problem. If you have three people, then it is already enough to identify some that some problem is common. If three different people have the same problem with the same thing, then it is probably something wrong with the software and it probably needs to be changed. So just tiny sample size is enough. And probably it is not the best idea to write scientific studies and to create some theories about general human experience and how and to recommend political solution based on asking and looking how three people are doing something. But it is more than enough to improve software. And yes, if you ask three people that have not managed to run away from you and you were asking them to help, then it will be non-representative sample. It will be not ideal reflection of everything, but it is already very, very, very useful. And it was mentioned at the start, so it's not a great surprise, but why I think that it is worth doing, mostly because I have done it. There is a StreetComplete. It is an editor for, let's say, for human beings. It's intended as being usable immediately, to not require going through tutorials, not starting with you should take tutorial and learn how to use the interface. And it's definitely not replacement for proper editors. It is not solution for everything, but it is especially useful for regular people who are interested in OpenStreetMap, but would spend, say, 5 minutes a day, for example, during walk or when they're waiting on the bus stop or during similar event, but are unwilling to spend half of a day to add a shop. So it is working by scanning OpenStreetMap data, detecting places with data missing. For example, road without surface data. There is information that a recycling container, but there is no information what can be left there. Or, for example, there is bicycle parking and it is possible to collect. Is it covered? Is it how large it is? What type of bicycle parking it is? And so there are these coded questions. And they are supposed to be easy to answer. So it is authored not by me, definitely not by me. I only joined when it was already a great app, and I was it was the best recommendation that I had, because I never before made anything in Android. I had a prepared plan about app that I want to implement. I had this all the specification and zero experience. And then I discovered that someone already had the same idea and implemented my specification, and even did in several places in much smarter way than I planned. So I joined the project, and nowadays I am a quite active contributor. So I actually made two such tests. There are links here, but probably typing into some search engine what is the last line will get you to it and will get better results without typing all the link. And it was basically, like I mentioned, recruiting some people, looking at their screens when they are using the app, and then fixing the problems, not all the problems. You always detect more problems, more ideas than you can fix. Some problems are obvious to spot, not obvious to fix at all. So many tiny issues, some big ones, some remain unsolved. But it was very, very useful. So, for example, what I learned. The most obvious, but only after I learned about it, is that when you are developing the app, you are using it for a long time, you no longer have experience of someone who is using it for the first time. And one of the changes was to delay asking user to log in. Because when someone opens the app, gives his location permission, looks at the interface for the first time, answers the first question, and immediately is attacked by you should log in to OpenStreetMap, it is too confusing. So nowadays, app waits a few edits, so user can solve few quests, and only then there is she or he gets a request to log in, so data can be submitted. And it is intended to be less confusing and more welcoming. Another discovery that was very helpful was that when you are experienced user or even made or wrote something, then you are not noticing that description is confusing. And when someone is using app for the first time, they will be actually confused by confusing things. And you can then fix and improve places where descriptions make no sense or can be misinterpreted. And also, some actions are not often done by someone who is expert. For example, answering question, and in the middle of answering question, accidentally exiting menu and losing all the data. It happens, but it happens especially for someone new. And there is protection against such loss of data, but for some quests it was broken, and it was discovered when users actually ran into it. And kind of a general lesson, that reality is more complicated than expected. Maybe not everything, but almost everything is more complicated. So things like distinguishing between asphalt and dirt and paving stones. It may be obvious, but it's not actually so obvious. Or even there was a picture of, I think, square paving stones, someone was mapping in place where there were hexagonal paving stones, and they were getting confused. So nowadays the picture is including more clear example. And also another problem that is basically never reported, because some of these problems that I mentioned, you get issue bug reports that something is problematic. But new mappers, someone who tried the app and ran away because it was too confusing, is very, very unlikely to report something. They will just do something else. And experienced users who are opening issues are always asking for adding something new, for adding something more complicated, more powerful, and almost no one will ask, hey, this feature I use once a year, but it is confusing for new mappers, let's remove it. Basically, no one will propose it. So such testing is also useful to find things that were confusing, that were unclear to new mappers, and can be hidden or removed to protect against confusion, even if it is something that is a bit of loss for power mappers. For example, StreetComplete is no longer asking by default, you can still enable it, about shapes of the roofs. It is useful for some 3D display, but it was too confusing, too time consuming, and too crushing for new mappers, because if every building asks you about interpreting its shape of the roof and it's not really fitting to anything, and then someone is spending 5 minutes or philosophical analysis which roof type is the most fitting, that is not really the most productive use of time and is really discouraging from use. And someone who is really interested can still enable it. And there are some limitations. For many projects, that is not a good idea, especially for projects that are someone is adding some, creating some software for themselves and is sharing with world. That is perfectly fine, and they are not obligated to make spend time on adding features, supporting more hardware, releases, and publicity, maintaining 20 Twitter accounts, and so on. No one is obligated to do this. So there should not be obligated to spend time on that. And some software is actually not benefiting from such testing because it is actively evil. I have no proof, but I am quite convinced that Facebook privacy settings were tested with such user testing and were actions taken to make it as confusing as possible. The same goes from the upgrading to Windows 10, when you had options OK, cancel, and you had option to close the window. OK, wait, it was OK, wait, and you have this cross button on the alert, and pressing wait was actually waiting. OK was upgrading to Windows 10, and closing by closing the cross button on top was also updating to Windows 10. I'm not sure is it accidental or deliberate thing to confuse people, but it could be result of user testing with the goal not to make software usable, but to make it to increase some metrics. And I actually could do this because I got a grant from NL Net Foundation, funded from European Union, and I actually, when I was making proposal for this grant, I had a bit trouble to fill things that I am planning to do. And I remembered the story about this hallway testing and beer testing. I just put this user testing as one of things that I am planning to do. And it was actually a very good idea. It worked well, and I can recommend it. So just, I know I have 2 seconds. One hint about recruiting. You can ask friends, family, you can bribe people, you can distract the random people on the hallway and ask for help. And I also, I'm doing it right now because I am still want to test it a bit. So if someone can spot me and is interested in trying to use StreetComplete as I look at how they are trying and maybe failing, then tell me and I will gladly test it. Okay, so no questions. Anyone has questions?
Thank you, Mateusz. I'm picking just one, and I see already a couple of hands from the online, and is asking something that you've mentioned. Does StreetComplete collect any analytics, like how often people answer, I don't know, on a question? And if so, did you use those during your experiment?
Okay, the analytics are what is available to anyone, because anyone can look at edits that people made. And yes, it is influence. For example, I am more likely to spend time on improving something that is used by many people than by, for example, quest that is solved 500 times in entire history of the StreetComplete. And I'm more likely to spend time on surface quest that is solved in times measured in millions, I think. So yes, it has influence, and I was also trying to look at how people are using, which quests are more popular and which way, but most what I learned is that it's really hard to do science and analyze data and produce something useful, because it's really easy to discover some false narrative and have a statistical proof, and it can be completely false. And I created such discoveries 5 times that I noticed some pattern. Then after looking into more, discovered that pattern is completely illusion and wrong. So it is quite tricky to actually use such statistics.
Thanks for the talk. I guess you described a really good way of finding usability problems in software, but then the next step is deciding how to fix it. And once you have a fix, deciding if the fix is sort of an improvement or not. Do you have any advice about how to do that? And maybe one question is, like, the same person that sort of discovers a problem, would you, for example, ask them what they would expect instead, or for ideas how to fix it?
Okay, so the question is, sorry if I heard you, so the problem is identified, and what is the next step? And okay, in my case, I am primarily implementing things. So if problems was obvious and easy to fix, it was basically fix it immediately. For example, things like wrong translation or some quest appearing for things where it's not supposed to appear, or graphic that is confusing and easy to change. The best is to basically change it immediately, and there is improvement. For things that are very time consuming to fix, maybe file some issue and mention that is a popular problem and worth fixing. And sometimes it is actually already reported, but it was no action was taken. So if something is common problem that is can increase change, that specific feature bug will be actually implemented. And I mentioned that I published these reports. A typical report has long list of tiny issues that were identified and fixed already, and discussion about major common problems that were spotted and there is no yet fix. So it's basically either fix something immediately or document the problem and likely fix in future.
Thanks.
Any more questions?
Okay, and just in case that someone is interested in slides itself, I also publish in some repository. I think the slides will be also shared from state of the map, but just in case that someone wants to have them immediately, they're free to get access to them.
Mateusz, I have a curiosity. You were talking about beer contact or something like that. Is it possible, or have you tried to have online testing with a one-on-one while they were playing with the app? Is it something that could be scalable?
It depends on the program. In case of StreetComplete, it is very hard to do because it is intended to be used on survey. So many problems are impossible to spot without full view of the environment. For example, one of problems identified was that it was common problem that when question about is this road lit during night was asked during the day, and many people were putting wrong answers because there was one place where there were not regular street lamps, but the way was lit by massive lamps on the nearby expressway. And it was something that to discover this problem, you need to be on place or have a few 3D view of the environment. But for example, for user testing of, for example, DOSM, or user testing of, I don't know, registration form on the OpenStreetMap website, or testing how ID is used, then it would work. It depends on how application is used. StreetComplete is supposed to be used on surveys, so that makes it really hard to do online testing.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. If it's all for online and offline, sorry, I missed one question. Do the answers given on StreetComplete automatically override the additions made on, for example, OSM ID editor? Are they somehow double checked against the existing data?
Okay, that is actually one of features that was added recently, is to when someone is adding surface info and it is conflicting with track type info on the same road, then user is asked to confirm, is it actually true? Are they sure about the answer? But in general, the app first adds missing data, and the resurvey is very, very old data. So in general, StreetComplete user is trusted to answer correctly, and any app is not going to protect against someone who is answering completely false data. If you lie and add fake data, then app is not going to stop you. And also asking all the time, are you sure is not practicable, and is going to annoy users who are actually adding correct data, and is not going to stop someone who is damaging data.
Same in the ID and JOSM, yeah. Thank you again, Mateusz, for this presentation. Very nice. And thank you all for participation in this session. I think now
I have one thing. If someone has, I don't know, feedback comments, feel free to say me to say to me also when, let's say, I can do something better or similar. Also, if you are if you have experience with StreetComplete or want to try use, feel free to find me and I will be glad to hear about it.